Back on the north side, 9:03. The tarp was removed from the infield, but it was a muddy mess underneath. So the Wrigley's grounds crew been working hard since right around 9 o'clock now, almost an hour and a half, trying to get this diamond back in shape. They've dumped around 60 bags of diamond dry on the surface. If and when they get ready to play ball, we'll take you back to Wrigley. Cubs leading 2-0, bottom of the fifth. They are surveying the situation now and seeing if the surface is playable. Got time for Inside the Lines, brought to you by Scotch Blue Painter's Tape. And since the start of last season, nobody beats the Riz, except Giancarlo Stanton and Paul Goldschmidt. Rizzo has grown into a premier power hitter. His 52 homers since the start of the 2013 campaign, third best in the National League over that span. Inside the Lines, brought to you by Scotch Blue Painter's Tape. Scotch Blue, see what you can do.
Much more baseball to get to. Southside All-Stars from Jackie Robinson West continue their quest for the ultimate Little League prize. Notre Dame got back to work, and their new kind of signal caller reminisces about a lost season after a dream season. And the Bears moved indoors to prepare for an opponent that they won't even meet on the field Friday night. We'll explain as Sportsnet Central rolls on. And right now you are looking live at Clark and Addison. Bruce Bochy, Rick Renteria, Cubs grounds crew surveying the field, along with the umpiring crew, Jed Hoyer down in the Cubs dugout, along with the likes of Crane Kenny. They're still trying to sort this thing out on whether the field is playable. We will keep you updated as soon as we know something here on Comcast Sports.
Sports has sort of fueled me, given me a reason to hope and believe in my own dreams, because some of the stories you hear, you can't write a better script. When people tell you that you can't achieve something, they're really questioning your heart. You can question a lot of things, but heart, you can't. You need to fight for what you believe in and fight for what you stand for. I just want to inspire people to be better and to believe in themselves. This isn't just about a runner with cerebral palsy that's training for a marathon. This is about, we all get knocked down in life, and it's the ability to get back up and keep moving forward that makes the difference.
Sunday at 10:30 on Sportsnet Central. Join us for an inspirational story about an amazing man running the Chicago Marathon. Jeff Hobbs will be the first to cross the finish line with his kind of cerebral palsy. It's a story that you cannot miss. Sunday, 10:30 only on Comcast Sportsnet.
Sportsnet Central on Comcast Sportsnet is presented to you by GMC. We are professional grade.
At GMC, the summer sell down is on. Now get the best selection of remaining 2014 GMC Sierra models while they last. And with 2 years of scheduled maintenance included, August is a great time to step up to professional grade. Pay no interest for 5 years on the 2014 GMC Sierra. Plus, for a limited time only, get $1,000 for crew cab models in stock the longest. But hurry, these 2014 GMC models won't last long.
Shouldn't we repeal Obamacare? It comes with a hefty price tag, a price tag Congressman Brad Schneider voted to keep. Just here in Chicago and Cook County, we're faced with a $67 million shortfall. Schneider's vote to keep Obamacare will cost taxpayers $2 trillion, drive up health insurance premiums and deductibles, and cause local businesses to cut back workers' hours from full-time to part-time. Tell Brad Schneider, Obamacare's price tag, it's just too much. Repeal it.
Come into Steak and Shake for real hand-dipped milkshakes. Better yet, come into Steak and Shake for real hand-dipped milkshakes at half price during Half Price Happy Hour, weekdays 2 to 4 at Steak and Shake. The $4 menu at Steak and Shake featuring handcrafted steak burgers, all beef footlongs, and fresh guacamole made from scratch. The $4 menu, where all meals are under $4 at Steak and Shake.
Matt, what do we got going on here today?
Well, we put an addition on this home.
Before we start painting, obviously we got to prep. We got exterior and interior 3M Scotch-Blue Painter's Tape. The exterior tape can hold up to the elements, the wind, the rain, the hot sun, the humidity. It has a waterproof backing. One of my favorite things about this tape, it has a quick snap tear. Also, it comes off cleanly up to 7 days. It's the perfect tape to use for exterior painting. Available at the Home Depot.
At the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event, you'll discover what happens when we cut corners. The corners of test tracks, where we engineered our most track-tested line of performance vehicles ever. The result, our gold standard of performance. And the only place you'll find it is at the Lexus Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Lease the all-wheel drive 2014 GS 350 for $409 a month for 27 months, and we'll make your first month's payment. See your Lexus dealer.
We are back on Sportsnet Central with our Bears preseason coverage presented by Apt. And if the Bears wanted a legitimate test of how good they are in the most important preseason game, they probably couldn't find a better one than who they'll face on Friday night.
Threatening skies above Halas Hall wasn't the only reason the Bears chose to move practice indoors. It was also an opportunity to prepare for Seattle's famous 12th man. The Seahawks crowd at CenturyLink Field, whose noise level will be in mid-season form to cheer on their defending champion Seahawks.
It's rough as a younger guy to go into a stadium like that and know at times it's going to be hard to hear in the huddle. Third preseason game, I'm sure that not only will the team be amped up, but the fans know it's the closest to a regular season game they're going to get. So it's going to be a good experience for them.
Any third preseason game is a good test to see where you're at, because that's when most of the starters are playing for an extended period of time, and also, you actually game plan a little bit against them.
We have to go there and play. It's going to be loud. It's going to be a test for our offense. It's going to be a test for each one of us individually up front. And we just have to make sure that we're ready to go.
I like the group of guys that we have in the locker room, understand what we're doing offensively. And it's early. It's still preseason with you guys.
This trip to Seattle also prepares the Bears for a big game environment and closer to defining themselves on special teams, including candidates who are expecting to fill the shoes of the departed Devin Hester.
Anytime you're in a competition, you got to be excited, and what better place to do it at than in Chicago?
My main thing was just staying in shape, and whenever a team does call, I'm right up in a porous. I feel like I never left playing football, so right now, my main thing was getting in shape, and I showed a lot yesterday that I was in shape, and here I am.
We're not fully game planning this team. We're still going to go out and work, but there'll be the matchups that we're looking for, and it'll be ones-on-ones for however long we do it. We'll see what happens as these matchups take place throughout the game, but we're not going to take ourselves to a place where it means more than it is.
Notre Dame football has been built on legendary stories like the backfield of their 1924 team, the Four Horsemen. A far cry from Brian Kelly's four players that are expected to miss significant, if not all, the upcoming season because of academic fraud. I'm sure Newt Rockne had a speech for classroom conduct. Kelly does too. And while it doesn't seem to be a message received by all of his players, they've all heard it.
It's harder at Notre Dame, but if it was easy, then it wouldn't be special. That's why Notre Dame's special. It's harder here. But the benefits that you get by coming to Notre Dame far outweigh so many other universities. But there are no shortcuts, and our guys know it. They're held accountable for it. And that's why there's not a huge issue within our football team, because they know what they sign up for when they come here. They know what the expectations are. They know what to expect when they come here. They know they're accountable on a day-to-day basis.
And nobody knows that more than quarterback Everett Golson. Next week, he will get the start in the first game of the year against Rice. It'll be exactly 600 days since Golson last played for the Irish in the national championship game. David Kaplan with Golson's journey before and after he was asked to leave the university.
He was spotty in attendance. He was at times late You know, he wasn't doing the things leaders do.
That's just me being young.
That was 2012 and a national championship run for the Irish, led by Everett Golson's play on the field. Off the field was a different story. Academic issues caught up with the QB. He sat out the entire 2013 season for what he admitted was cheating on a test.
The first couple games, it was kind of embarrassing, to be honest. You know, I watched the Temple game. And, you know, I felt kind of bad, you know, just seeing all those guys out there. I think the biggest thing I saw Amir, you know, break off on that run. Mm-hmm. And it just really sunk in, like, oh, man, I'm not there.
Last week, he was officially named the starter for 2014, and he has the confidence of his head coach.
He knows what great leadership looks like, and he's paid attention to it and knows what it looks like, and now he's that guy out in front, and he's not the guy behind.
Well, he has the keys to the offense. He's the guy who really is the puppet master who's pulling the strings, even though Coach Kelly's calling the plays. He's got some adjustments that he can make. He's done a great job with those in camp.
Golson will be counted on as a leader of a team that Brian Kelly says is one of his youngest he's ever had as a head coach. Covering the Irish, I'm David Kaplan, Comcast Sports.
Cap, thanks. Ohio State's Big Ten and national title hopes suffered a huge blow after test results confirmed that senior quarterback Braxton Miller will miss the upcoming season. He re-injured his surgically repaired right shoulder while throwing a pass in Monday's practice. Buckeyes are ranked fifth in the AP preseason poll. They now likely turn to redshirt freshman JT Barrett as their starting quarterback. I know the Sparties want to win that division fair and square. Hate to see something like that happen, but it certainly helps their hopes. The 12-year-olds from Morgan Park survived Monday night's roller coaster ride and elimination from the Little League World Series, blowing a 6-2 lead, but managing to overcome Rhode Island 8-7. Their reward? Another do-or-die game 24 hours later versus a team from Pearland, Texas. But Team Illinois had Houston, Joshua Houston, that is, on the mound. He came out dealing in the first. Striking out the side, he'd go on to throw a dominating five frames, allowing only four hits and one run. Now to the bottom of the fourth, Houston helping himself out at the dish. Doubling deep to left to give Jackie Robinson West a 6-1 lead as he plates two on that hit. And that would turn out to be your final, an outstanding two-way performance from Houston as Jackie Robinson West stays alive again, pulling to within one win of the United States Championship.
6-1, you know, it was all the way to the end. It's pretty important. We live to fight another day.
Thought they would hit a little more, but we didn't. They play really good defense, so awesome game.
Unfortunately, we had to come out of loser's bracket, but we're putting wins together in bunches, and let's keep that up.
I'm excited for the city of Chicago, you know, state of Illinois. It's just a lot going on right now, so I'm super excited.
Let's check in on the White Sox top pitching prospect as tonight's GMC professional grade player. This past June's number 3 overall draft pick, Carlos Rodon, his AAA debut for Charlotte in a start against the Gwinnett Braves. Still left you allowed one hit and one run over 3 innings, fanning 3, walking 3, tossed 55 pitches, 35 of those for strikes. Back to the majors, Angels taking on the Red Sox at Fenway. LA entered a half game up on Oakland in the AL West. 1-1 in the third, Mike Trout. Blast one off the Green Monster. Ball taking a strange bounce off the scoreboard. Trout ends up all the way at third for a triple. Angels on top. 3 all though in the ninth. Chris Iannetta doubling high off the Monster to drive in the go-ahead run. And that would be your difference as the Angels capture their second straight 4-3. You're fine.
Should Derrick Rose continue his comeback with Team USA despite reports that he's experiencing knee discomfort? We'll cross over that topic. And it was another Hawk moment for the Archives. We'll relive the chilling Hawk walk in the latest Ice Bucket Challenge when Sportsnet Central rolls off. Once again, you're looking live at Clark and Addison. Rain-soaked confines, getting closer, we believe, to playing ball. They've been plowing off the top layer of the diamond dry and taking that away, trying to get this thing ready to go. I told Cap to grab a shovel, jump in his red Corvette and go help out. He needs another job, but he said no thanks. Wrigleyville Taverns probably enjoying this. We will have baseball eventually. Len and JD standing by. send it back to them as soon as they're ready to go.
Bears preseason coverage is presented by Apt Electronics, Appliances, and More since 1936.
For a little while, Happy Meals just $2.99.
If I told you that a free 10-second test could mean less waiting for things like security backups and file downloads, you'd take that test, right? But what are you waiting for? You could literally be done with the test by now. Now you could have done it twice. This is awkward.
Go to ComcastBusiness.com/checkyourspeed. If we can't offer faster speeds or save you money, we'll give you $150. Comcast Business, built for business.
If ever you're not satisfied with one of our tires, please feel free to bring it back. Thank you. Discount Tire Company.
Ah, the $4 menu presents many options, yet grants us only one stomach. Master?
How does one decide between the original double and cheese?
Or the fresh guacamole steak burger.
The garlic double steak burger.
Or an all-beef Chicago-style footlong.
How do you decide, Master?
Pictures.
The $4 menu, where all meals are under $4. At Steak and Shake.
Tomorrow, the White Sox and Orioles meet for the final time in 2014. And the boys on the South Side look to close with a win. White Sox, Orioles, tomorrow at 7 on Comcast SportsNet. Cap'n Hall Rewind, weeknights at 11.
Ever wonder why an icy cold Coke seems to taste so good at McDonald's? Is it because any size Coca-Cola, soft drink, or sweet tea is just a dollar? Or is it something you can't explain? Maybe it's just more happiness to love.
The web is full of random stats and opinions.
But when it comes to the Bears, you can bet your season tickets. CSNChicago.com is bringing you the facts. John Moonmullen gives you an NFL vet's perspective and always has the inside track. Live post-game streams give you an instant reaction from Soldier. And Bears Pulse shows you what's trending at Soldier Field. From Bears fans, for Bears fans. The Bears page on CSNChicago.com.
Bears made a bunch of special teams moves over the last 24 hours, among them signing return specialist Darius Raynaud, who most recently appeared with the Jets last season, the season before he led the NFL in total kick return yards, scored 3 return touchdowns. Could be another Bear that sees the bulk of the returns on Friday night, as our Moon Mullen explains in this View from the Moon.
One of the huge topics for this team throughout the preseason, the offseason, has been who replaces Devin Hester. What will be one of the things worth watching is going to be the fate and the performances of Chris Williams. He will be getting his first chance, really, to return kicks this game. He played against Philadelphia, hurt himself on a pass reception, so really hasn't had a chance to show what he can do. But the key is going to be what he does when he gets the ball in his hands on kickoffs and punts. He also has the ability to function as a pass receiver, so he puts himself really at the head of the returner class because he can do two things on game day, very important for the Bears.
Chris Sheridan was first to report that Derrick Rose is experiencing knee pain. That's why he was held out of today's Team USA workout. So we asked you, should the Bulls ask him to withdraw from the team? Well, here's what you had to say. Tyler said, I think he should withdraw because we want him healthy so we can hear Stacey King's amazing commentary. Thank you, Stacey, for chiming in. Christian, no! He needs to get the rust off now before the season. Mike says, from someone who tore both ACLs, Derek needs to keep playing. He'll always have knee soreness. Build confidence now. Thank you for helping us out.
Especially Dr. Mike there. On the South Side again, Jose Abreu ending that 18-game homerless streak with the big fly to left center that turned into his 32nd homer of the season. That evened the game with Baltimore at 1. The Sox had only 2 other hits on the night. O's put up a 3 spot in the 6th off Jose Quintana, including that 2-run double by Chris Davis. In the 7th, Nick Hudley adding the finishing touch off of Daniel Webb. Solo shot to the seats and left. White Sox fall 5-1. They're now 8 games below 500, and Jose Quintana drops to 6-10 on the year.
still a little bit frustrated because I try, you know, keep the game close. I think bad looking when Jones too, really good pitch. You know, the boys in the line for right field. Yeah, Davis team a little bit down, but it's good pitch. Yeah, it's good hitter for low ball, Mario.
How tough is it for you? I mean, today was just, it was one inning. Last start, it was a replay, kind of got things going. But
yeah. The season.
I mean, how frustrating is that?
Yeah, it's really hard, you know. But my team, they need to keep working with us. It's one day that's changed for me. You know, my team, more preparation and keep going. That's it.
Got a live peek here at Wrigley Field. They've been going at this since about 9 o'clock when they began to take the tarp off the field and try to get the diamond back in working order. About 60 bags or so of the diamond dry. They've been in the process lately of taking that top layer of diamond dry off and getting the field ready to resume. And I'm sure Len Casper's gone through his iPod by now, like 4 playlists. He's ready to call some baseball. Cubs with a 2-0 lead. Going to the bottom of the 5th inning. As soon as they start playing, we'll send you back there.
At GMC, the summer sell-down is on. Now get the best selection of remaining 2014 GMC Sierra models while they last. And with 2 years of scheduled maintenance included, August is a great time to step up to professional grade. Pay no interest for 5 years on the 2014 GMC Sierra. Plus, for a limited time only, get $1,000 for crew cab models in stock the longest. But hurry, these 2014 GMC models won't last long.
Shouldn't we repeal Obamacare? It comes with a hefty price tag. A price tag Congressman Brad Schneider voted to keep. Just here in Chicago and Cook County, we're faced with a $67 million shortfall. Schneider's vote to keep Obamacare will cost taxpayers $2 trillion, drive up health insurance premiums and deductibles, and cause local businesses to cut back workers' hours from full-time to part-time. Tell Brad Schneider, Obamacare's price tag, it's just too much. Repeat.
Turning a 20-foot wall into a canvas takes vision. So we're getting into college. I've got what it takes. So do you.
At GMC, the summer sell-down is on. Now get the best selection of remaining 2014 GMC models while they last. Like the GMC Acadia, with standard rear view camera and rear park assist. And with 2 years of scheduled maintenance included, August is a great time to step up to professional grade. Now lease this 2014 GMC Acadia for around $299 per month. But hurry, these 2014 GMC models won't last long.
Visit CSNChicago.com for great deals on your favorite team's merchandise. From jerseys and hats to autographed memorabilia and more. Outfit yourself in your favorite team's gear and visit the fan shop at CSNChicago.com now.
Chicago District Golfer is celebrating the CDGA's 100th anniversary all year long with the best courses, insightful instruction, game-improving equipment, and interesting stories. Join me, Jill Carlson, on the first Sunday of every month at 9:30 p.m.
Coming up on Thursday, hang with Comcast Sportsnet at the Coors Light viewing party. Come to Pyramid Pizzeria and Sports Bar in Addison to win prizes, drink ice cold Coors Light, and watch the boys from the North Side take on San Francisco's finest. Be there Thursday, 7 o'clock. Great beer equals great responsibility.
The plays of the day are presented by Lexus.
Out to Williamsport for number 3, young Joshua Houston earns this spot, allowing just one run over 5 innings of work on the mound, also doubling home a pair of insurance runs in the 4th inning. Jackie Robinson-West goes on to win 6-1, survives another elimination game, and play another day in the Little League World Series.
Number 2, pair of crosstown homers. Jose Abreu going yard at U.S. Cellular, his first long ball since July 29th. Over at Wrigley, Anthony Rizzo depositing one on to Sheffield, his second homer as many days. slugging Chicago first baseman Cher, number two.
It's nice to share. And out to Fenway for number one, Boston's Brock Holt. Deep to right, Cole Calhoun tracks it back to the wall and makes the spectacular leaping grab. Larceny to Rob Holtz of a sure home run. Calhoun helps LA win at 4-3 and takes home our play of the day.
My first challenge is going to go out to one of the great left-handed relievers in Major League Baseball history, now with MLB Network, Dan Plesac. And my third challenge, when I announce this name, everybody in the White Sox organization is going to give me a standing ovation because it is our trainer, Herm Schneider. You are challenged. You're on the clock, buddy.
Hawk probably thought that shower cap was going to cover everything from the southpaw toss, but a closer look, the second bucket, the man in the purple shirt, that is Jim Thome, known for his long, prodigious home runs during his days with the White Sox, and he was the guy who later approached, and southpaw got the top. Hawk probably thought it was over with, and then Thome comes in with the finish. Good on Hawk, though, to take part in that ALS Ice Bucket Challenge and walk away with a little duck walk. And a
first one I've seen with the shower cap
as well.
Kudos to Hawk on that. Finally, Move Over Ice Bucket Challenge. Jimmy Fallon has a new event. Last night, Fallon had Tiger Woods and the world's number one golfer, Rory McIlroy, on The Tonight Show. And since Woods is injured, Jimmy invited McIlroy to take the Face Breakers Chipping Challenge, where you try and chip the ball, breaking the glass that has your opponent's face on it. Take a look.
The first one to break all of their opponent's faces is the champion. Tiger, you're going to be my coach.
Yeah, I'm just getting the balls lined up for you, sir.
I appreciate it. I love it. You're my caddy. This is the best thing ever.
Hit it harder.
Is that it?
No! One more!
Right there! Don't do it, Rory!
No! Oh, that's close.
Come on, Tiger Albee! Yeah. Zoom in on this. Where is this camera here? Zoom in. His name is already engraved in the trophy. You have no faith in your host? Who made this thing?
Make it four straight events that Rory has now won.
And three majors.
Yeah,
he's won. He's won everything else this year, so it would have been bad if he didn't win that.
Like, Fallon's now trying to get on Ryder Cup.
Yeah.
That's what I hear.
This has been Sports Set Central, presented by GMC. I'll be back whenever this Cubs game is over.
They just announced over the PA system at Wrigley that both teams hope to continue playing tonight, so the Wrigley Field grounds crew working hard to get this diamond back into shape. If and when they get ready to play, we'll have it for you on CSN.
At GMC, the summer sell down is on. Now get the best selection of remaining 2014 GMC Sierra models while they last. And with 2 years of scheduled maintenance included, August is a great time to step up to professional grade. Pay no interest for 5 years on the 2014 GMC Sierra. Plus, for a limited time only, get $1,000 for crew cab models in stock the longest. But hurry, these 2014 GMC models won't last long.
With Luna, take 40% off your entire project. That's 40% off carpet, hardwood, and laminate. 40% off padding and materials. And 40% off installation. Reserve your appointment now.
773-202 Luna.
That ball is out of here. You can put it on the board. Yes! Just a line shot that did not come down.
You got him. 3-1 on the out.
It's 21 game hit streak for El Hombre, the man.
Here's Mr. Dangerous, Jose Abreu.
That ball hit high and deep. Way back. He looks up.
If ever you're not satisfied with one of our tires, please feel free to bring it back. Thank you. Discount Tire Company.
Bryan Brothers are busy guys.
Let's get out of here.
Road trip.
So Esurance is using technology to help them see New York.
Should have brought a camera. You are a camera.
Bring cash.
Kind of like how they use technology to help you make smart choices about your insurance.
Nice shot, Fika. U.S. Open, please.
It's just how they roll.
That was fun.
Man, I'm exhausted.
Esurance, proud sponsor of the U.S. Open.
Chapter 13 debt repayment plans deal with lawsuits, foreclosures, car payments, credit cards, payday loans, repos, tax debts, medical bills, and more. I'm attorney Peter Francis Geraci. Get one lower payment for all debt and stop creditors now. Call us for a free phone mini consultation or log on to infotapes.com.
If you're worried about debt, call now to see if you qualify. 1-800-401-4010.
Cap'n Hall Rewind, weeknights at 11.
The Sonata premiere event featuring the dramatically redesigned 2015 Hyundai Sonata. It's the first Sonata with forward collision warning, the first with lane departure warning, and the first to earn the Insurance Institute's highest safety rating. So the next time you hear the phrase safety first, think Sonata first.
Lease the all-new 2015 Sonata for $199 a month. Visit buyhyundai.com.
I'm David Kaplan. He's David Haas. She is Brooke Weisbrod. Ben Finfer here throughout the morning. Trey Elling, our executive producer. Matt Rooney, our associate producer. And Pat Costell, I call him PG-13, is our superstar director. Good morning, D-Haw.
Morning, Cap. How are you?
What's up
morning,
with you, Brooke? Buddy?
Morning.
Good day. Good night. Had a lot of fun over at the Cell yesterday and watching some Monday Night Football.
Yeah, I saw a little of it. We had multiple TVs going. I watched the Little League game in its entirety.
Okay, so last night you have opportunity to choose between watching your guy,
mm-hmm.
Johnny Manziel, Monday Night Football, and the Jackie Robinson West team, Little League World
I have three
Series.
TVs in the basement.
Ooh, three TVs
so
in the basement.
I had Chris Sale going. I had the Browns going, but on the big screen I had, the other ones are little. Yeah. I had the big screen going with Jackie Robinson West. I'm caught up in it, love it, enjoy it. It was a lot of fun.
They won. It's great to see. It's a great story. I think any positive story that involves the south side of Chicago and kids playing baseball, you have to, even though I have some reservations about what putting 12-year-olds on national television and documenting their every little thing that they do and every at bat and every emotion, I do think that, you know what, this is a nice story. It's a great story for Chicago. The best thing on television last night, though, was the post-game speech from the losing coach.
He was outstanding.
That is a lesson in sportsmanship, in grace, in humility, not just for sports, but that is the best thing you will see on the internet today.
Yeah, he was phenomenal. I like the way he approached the game during the game when they have him mic'd. And I'm pitching to you. Just imagine it's me. I thought he conducted himself with a lot of class.
He did. And I think that's what it's all about. You lose sight of that sometimes when you are hanging on every pitch and every at-bat of a 12-year-old kid. And, you know, when you hear reports about these kids, it's they're rock stars and they're signing autographs. You worry about the loss of perspective necessarily. But when you hear a coach like that say what he said, it's reassuring. So, yeah, congratulations to him because he handled it well. And that was good to see. So that was great television last night. You had the Johnny Manziel mess that we'll talk about. A couple of news things that were interesting. I thought Santonio Holmes handled himself like a pro in his first day as a Bear. I thought he handled the questions like you would expect him to. He did not come in like a prima donna.
I was listening to Connor and Carmen last night, and they were critical of him that he was kind of surly with the media. I didn't think he was at all.
I wasn't there. I was at the Cell, so I can't speak to how he was when the cameras were off.
Now, the question was asked, how are you after, you know, the injuries? He said, I'm on the field.
Yeah.
What's wrong with that answer?
Nothing. You know, he's been 9 years in the league. This is not a guy that's going to come in wide-eyed at anything. I think that when you look at the way that he handled himself, it was efficient. It was no nonsense. Was there a bit of an edge? I don't know. I wasn't there. I talked to a couple people who were that didn't sense that. So you'd like to see that because he's got to be a professional in this environment. You'd like to see him have a two-week tryout, in essence, that you know leads to him playing a role in this offense. I thought he handled himself well. So that was interesting. And I think the really big college football news today is not that it's Notre Dame Media Day, although that could create its own set of headlines. You never know what's going on in South Bend. But Braxton Miller, front page of the Tribune today, quarterback for Ohio State, could be a season-ending injury. And that is big. That is too bad. and unfortunate for him, but it definitely changes the scope of the Big Ten.
No question. Everyone else has life.
Well, you know, Ohio State has depth, and they always will, and that's why they're Ohio State, and Urban Meyer is, for my money, one of the top, you know, three coaches in America, so he's going to find a way to coach through this, but you don't lose a player of that caliber and not notice it, and it doesn't, without it having repercussions on the rest of the league. So definitely huge story in college football to follow. And they'll have somebody else emerge. They always do, but you feel bad for the kid because he comes back. He
works hard after an injury.
Yeah, and that's just, you know, for it to happen now, it's a shoulder.
By the way, I'd like to see the Cubs or White Sox sign Marquise Jackson. He's the closer for Jackie Robinson West.
You're gonna go there.
This kid is filthy. Do you know how hard
Theo or Jed have any scouts in the audience? I think they're scouting the Little League World Series.
Do you know how hard he throws?
Is he under team control?
He's not represented by Scott Boris, is
exactly. He is not, so his clock has not started. Not a problem. So they put the radar gun up for the kids.
Which I hate.
And then
that's part of it I hate,
so
Cap.
It comes up, it says, 71 miles an hour. And then it says, MLB, what it translates to, because they're throwing from 46 feet.
Yeah.
This kid threw 100.
Yeah.
100.
I know. And how do you feel about that?
So, whatever.
I know. 12-year-olds breaking off curveballs and...
That I don't like.
Throwing, crazy innings. And I understand. I understand. I'm trying hard. This is a fun story. I don't want to throw cold water, the ice bucket challenge, on the whole Little League World Series, because it is fun and it is a positive story. And there's a lot to like about, again, what it says and has done for these kids on the south side of Chicago and in communities everywhere across America that are represented here. But I don't like looking at a Little League game and seeing a jugs gun. I don't like looking at a Little League game and hearing about velocity and,
I don't know if they have it in the stadium. It may just be on TV.
Well, that's enough, isn't it? I mean, on TV.
Then don't let your kid play.
No.
I have no problem with it.
Do you really think that you start your kid playing Little League baseball thinking, boy, one day he's going to be on, ESPN. No, you do it because it's fun. It's social. It's sports.
Yeah, I have no problem with it. About that. My wife was locked in on the game. We watched the whole thing. Did not go up to bed until that game was over. Many times we're watching a show.
You switch the channels, though. You watch a little. What surprised me last night? You must have been locked in. You must have been really locked in on Little League Baseball.
I was.
Because you had no clue that your guy, Johnny Manziel, made a fool out of himself on ESPN, the other ESPN.
It wasn't that big a deal.
He flipped off the team. He flipped off the Redskins.
Okay. Yeah. Mike Ditka has done it. Many guys have done it. It's not AJ has done it.
There are two things here. Okay, number one, I don't disagree with you that it happens in football. It's not that big of a deal. But you mentioned Mike Ditka, and I knew you would go this route. It's so predictable. Look, you're going to defend your guy and brush it off. I'm going to look at it this big picture.
Shouldn't happen, and he's wrong.
It was classless. He looked like a clown. But it does reaffirm the fact, what I think a lot of people believe, he's just not ready to be an NFL quarterback yet. And you don't need him flipping off the Redskins to tell you that. All you have to do is watch the film.
So if he was a 7-year vet and he did it, what would you say then?
Classless, and he looked like a clown.
But it doesn't mean he's not ready to be an NFL quarterback.
You're confusing what I'm saying here. It's all part of the bigger picture. I'm not overreacting to him flipping off the crowd. That wasn't the biggest thing, I think, that is problematic.
It wasn't
for
actually
the crowd. Browns.
He flipped off the sidelines.
The sidelines. Oh, well, that's different then.
That is.
Because when the Redskins are laughing at him after the game. They're saying, hey, we got under his skin, and they were laughing at him. This guy's overreacting. Again, it feeds into the whole idea. Johnny Manziel is not ready or equipped to be an NFL. Let me finish.
Go ahead.
He's not ready to be an NFL starting quarterback because you can't.
Because Brian Hoyer's so good?
No. Has nothing to do with Brian Hoyer. He's not going to. If he wins this job, it'll be by default. But if you watch the first two games, biggest problem isn't Johnny Manziel's gestures to his opponent. The problem is he can't complete 50% of his passes and look like an NFL pocket passer. That's his biggest problem right now. He is not an NFL-ready quarterback. You look around the league, you see Bortles, you see Teddy Bridgewater taking a step, you see other rookies much further along in their NFL development than this guy is, who's getting all this attention for obvious reasons, but he's not handling it so well right now.
Yeah, the fact that he flipped off the Redskins, some of his teammates said, boy, the stuff they were saying is so unprintable.
No big deal.
Can't happen. Shouldn't do it.
You think every quarterback doesn't hear that stuff?
Right. Johnny Football made a mistake. He apologized for it. He owned it. It is what it is. Big deal. Tiger swears when he hits a bad shot, everyone freaks out. They're at work. Big deal. Whatever. Happens. Don't do it again.
It's a sign of immaturity from a guy prone to it. And I think that's a concern when you're talking about the position, which is expected for him to show leadership traits that you don't expect your wide receiver or your right guard or your pass-rushing defensive end. Your quarterback's different. Act like it.
Save big during the Great Summer Clearance Event at The Great Escape. Clearance prices on remaining patio furniture, pools, outdoor accessories, hot tubs, and more. Only at The Great Escape.
This Friday and Saturday, you can double your rebate. Get up to $250 in Visa prepaid cards when you buy select tire and wheel packages with your Discount Tire credit card. Double your rebate this Friday and Saturday. Thank you, Discount Tire.
The Sonata premiere event featuring the dramatically redesigned 2015 Hyundai Sonata. It's the first Sonata with forward collision warning, the first with lane departure warning, and the first to earn the Insurance Institute's highest safety rating. So the next time you hear the phrase safety first, think Sonata first.
Lease the all-new 2015 Sonata for $199 a month. Visit buyhyundai.com.
One network captures the most exhilarating moments in Chicago sports. Comcast SportsNet. We understand your passion, and we're as obsessed as you are. This is Comcast SportsNet.
Tomorrow, the White Sox and Orioles meet for the final time in 2014, and the boys on the South Side look to close with a win. White Sox, Orioles, tomorrow at 7 on Comcast SportsNet.
Let's talk Notre Dame.
Yeah, because today is media day in South Bend.
Correct. So they have had no clarity yet that any of these guys have been cleared.
No, and I think that's I said yesterday that was sort of the undercurrent, and you hear that it's possible that that's going to happen. But I think still they want to, I don't want to say even give the appearances, but they have to be thorough in their investigation. And coming out on Monday after announcing the investigation on Friday would not leave the appearance of being thorough.
Well, I'm hearing that the football coach, Brian Kelly, others around him and in the athletic department, none too pleased with the head of academic support for athletics, Pat Holmes.
Right.
Now, Brian makes millions. Pat Holmes is a, I don't know what he makes, 85, 100, I don't know, whatever.
He's a cog in the machine.
But the question has to be asked, was academic support doing enough to help athletes so they didn't feel they had to cheat? Or were they going to cheat? Didn't matter.
That's the question that you have to ask if you are John Jenkins, the president, if you're Jack Swarbrick, the athletic director, and if you are the football coach, you want to know that. If you were the football coach by the same token, you already should know that. I really believe that you have to have if you are wondering, if you have to ask that question, you are already doomed, because you should have a tighter relationship and connection to the people that are responsible for handling this kind of thing, especially with the player in DeVaris Daniels who has encountered academic trouble before. Nothing that's happened to DeVaris Daniels' academic struggles in the past 6 months since he's returned should be a surprise to anybody on the football staff.
Okay, but what I think you're overlooking here is you went to school
and you took care of your books. Academic All-American, I'm not kidding around. I'm serious. Academic All-American, got your master's at Northwestern, the whole deal. But other kids struggle. They don't come in as prepared. They come from a background where,
I'm
man,
not
they're recruited
that.
As a heavy, big-time college football player, and they're just not as prepared for college life in an elite university like the University of Notre Dame. So if I'm the football coach and I've got 4 billion responsibilities that I got to take care of, and if I miss on any of them, I'm going to have David Haw and whoever else, Al
Lessar,
writing that I dropped the ball. I screwed up on this booster thing or that academic thing or that game plan or this kid, whatever. So my question to you is, if I'm Brian Kelly, mm-hmm. you're Pat Holmes, mm-hmm. Pat, got our daily meeting here. What's going on academically? Kids are good. Think everything's fine.
Okay.
Now, if you tell me he went to Brian and said, we got issues. We got kids that are drowning here in academics, and I don't know what to do with them, and they did nothing, fine. But I don't think that was the case.
I don't know that, but how do you know that? See, I don't know if they've had those conversations. It sounds like they haven't based on people that we've spoken with or some of the reporting, you know.
I mean, if you're in charge of academic support services for athletics.
Well, hold on a second. So
some of it falls at your feet.
Yeah, no question about it. I mean, this does not reflect well on anybody at the university, and especially in the support staff, because these are kids, student-athletes. They're not kids, 18 to 22-year-olds. Some of them are 21-year-old men that have, you know, are being investigated for potentially taking alternate routes to getting their grades, mm-hmm. which isn't encouraged, but it does happen. And it's one of those things like when Brian Kelly said on Saturday that I don't know anything. I don't know where this stands. I don't know what's going on. And I asked him a question, and he probably sounded dumb when I asked it, but I said, as a coach, do you want to know? I mean, because if I'm defending you and I'm your lawyer, you know, it's a typical thing, and I'm a defense attorney, and I sense maybe you're guilty, but I don't want to know that because I have to defend you, right?
You can't ask.
Well, you can't ask, but you
can't in law, you cannot suborn perjury. That's the law.
Right, so you don't want to know that. You don't want to know the truth, right? You don't want to know the truth. You want to know the best defense mm-hmm. to be able to project.
It's our system. Everyone's entitled to a defense.
So from a football coaching standpoint, do you want to know everything? Should you know everything? Those are two different questions. I think that you, idealistically, you should know everything. You should know everything that's going on, but that's not very realistic. It's still it sounds crazy to say, but you are ultimately responsible for everything that happens on your watch as a football coach. But there are certain things that you probably limit the extent that you know because, you know, it's like, okay, how involved do you want to get in these four guys' academic schedules? Because you do have to worry about game planning for Rice or whatever. But you're ultimately held responsible for that, so you've got to make it your business. I really do think you have to make it your business. And if you're
okay, so how involved should he be? Because what if Brian, we don't know. We weren't at the
meeting. That's what his staff is for.
But what if Brian said, hey, every morning at 9 a.m., I need Pat in my office. I need 15 minutes. I want to know what's going on. And he says, Coach, we're good. Everybody's on top of their stuff. And then this scandal breaks, and he's like, okay, now world firing on me, and that's your area of expertise, and you told me everything was fine.
Well, then he failed, and ultimately Kelly, the head coach, failed, and both of them, along with other people, will be held accountable for that failure because that's the way it works.
Correct, but what I'm saying is right now the perception is that Brian Kelly dropped the ball. How could he not know his kids are this? Why were they doing that? When the person that... Again, I wasn't in the meeting, neither were you. The person who's in charge of that department, that would be like Jimmy DeCastro saying, I went to my sales manager and I asked, did you take care of the Chevrolet account? We're good. And then it blows up because he didn't. It blows back on Jimmy, but he put it on Jeff Hill, head of sales, and Jeff didn't come clean with him. Well, maybe the same thing happened with Pat Holmes. So I'm one of Brian Kelly's harshest critics, not just from this scandal. I'm not a fan. Would never let my kid play there for him.
Let's let it play out. That's why I cautioned you yesterday.
Pat Holmes is getting a bit of a free
pass. That's why I cautioned you yesterday. It's okay to be disappointed by this. It's okay to be critical of what this investigation may say about the football program and what it says positively maybe about the university. But I would caution you from saying, okay, Brian Kelly has to go because this is related to that and related to this. Look, I don't think it ultimately might reflect well on the football coach, but I don't know that we're there yet. I don't think that we have to rush to say, okay, he has failed and these are the consequences he must face. We just don't know. And as information
begins. That's what I said yesterday on TV.
But if it goes deeper.
STL.
Yeah, that's nicely done. Because I think if it goes deeper, those are tougher questions to
answer.
Correct.
If it comes out that he was aware, yeah, there's more investigation that has to be done.
Or if it extends beyond these four guys. And that's what you want to take this opportunity as a university, and you applaud them for doing this. That while you're looking into these four guys and what you think that they may or may not have done, keep digging, keep looking. You owe it to yourself if you want to make this part of your identity as to upholding the academic integrity of your football program. You know, you want to make sure that there aren't more people that could possibly be involved and more seasons that could have been affected, because, you know, the media wasn't the entity that brought up the idea of vacating victories in 2012.
It was Jack Swarbrick.
Yeah, it was Jack Swarbrick. John Jenkins mentioned it, and it's like, oh, that perked up some ears. 2012? They need to start talking to some people. And when you do, you think that it's probably a good idea that Notre Dame leaves no stone unturned, because there's a lot of smoke around that university right now. They need to find out if there's a fire.
Yeah, but my whole point of this debate is, again, I'm not a Brian Kelly guy. Not with you, the public discourse. I'm not a Brian Kelly guy, but it might be unfair to lay everything at his feet when he may have relied on someone in academic support to do their job, and maybe they didn't. I'm not saying they did or didn't. I'm asking the question. Should Pat Holmes assume some responsibility for what's going on right now? The University of Notre Dame football program.
And you can ask Brian Kelly that question, and he addressed it. And who's up to create the environment where this kind of thing either does or doesn't exist? The football coach.
Yeah,
do you have paid a culture of permissiveness? Is there a deterrent in place that makes every student athlete, every one of those 85 guys on scholarship, say, okay, if I have somebody write my paper for me, there's going to be retribution.
Consequences.
Yeah. I don't know that that exists. Even after Everett Golson, starting quarterback, lost a season of eligibility for doing something that was wrong, for cheating, that he admits, there still didn't exist this sort of fear. And it is fear. You should have fear. It's okay. You should be afraid that if I cheat, I'm losing my scholarship. I'm getting kicked out of a school that, you know, is been very good to me, that I...
And is highly prestigious.
And is going to give me a lifetime of opportunities. You should be afraid to cheat. And I just don't know that there's that sort of inherent, instilled culture that people, you know, this is happening. Or if it's, they're suspected, you can't call these guys guilty, but there's enough conversation about what they may or may not have done that I wonder about the culture there.
I'm just asking the question. Does Pat Holmes deserve some culpability? We'll find out.
Our moving day arrived.
But the movers didn't.
All my jewelry? Lost.
Looked like a tornado hit the back of the truck.
But moving my DirecTV? Piece of cake.
They were so professional.
And on time.
Even gave me a brand new genie.
Bundled the phone and internet too.
All the best sports for the boys.
It's like we never left. DirecTV was the best part of our move. By far.
The DirecTV Movers Deal. Call today and ask how to get NFL Sunday Ticket Max.
Lizzie, it's perfect.
I love it. This is sparkly. It's beautiful.
I love pink.
Mom, I don't wear pink anymore.
Really?
Ooh, but I love this top. I love this shirt. I love all the ruffles on it.
I really like these pants. I love the colors. They are so me.
It's really cute, Liz.
Mom.
Elizabeth.
Pink is definitely my color.
Really?
Before each NASCAR race, visit CSNChicago.com and enter the Chicagoland Speedway Sweepstakes. Send in your pick. Then watch Sports Talk Live every Tuesday. And if Scott Paddock randomly selects your pick, you'll win tickets to the NASCAR Spring Cup Series. Plus, you'll be entered to win the grand prize, a trip for two to the 2014 Spring Cup Series Award Ceremony at the Wynn Hotel in Las Vegas. Submit your race pick now and enter the Chicagoland Speedway Sweepstakes from Comcast Sportsnet.
The White Sox page on CSNChicago.com.
Tony Dungy and Phil Simms came out yesterday.
Right.
And both said, we are going to not use the word Redskins.
Two very accomplished, influential broadcasters.
Correct. And if I was running a TV network,
right,
whatever, NBC, CBS, Fox, whoever, and my analyst said, I am not going to use that name, and it's still the name of the team,
mm-hmm,
I would tell them, then you're not on the air. That's fine.
Well, it's already gotten clumsy because it should not have gotten to this point.
Correct.
Because you're how many weeks before the beginning of the regular season, and you have announcers for each respective networks giving their personal feelings about what they will or won't do during a broadcast when that should have all been established and all the talent, as you call it,
mm-hmm,
should have been instructed how to deal with this issue.
Correct.
When it comes up, because it's going to come up.
Correct.
And you know, shockingly maybe, I mean, I agree with you, because I believe that you can hold whatever beliefs you have about the Redskins name. And you can believe it's disrespectful, it's offensive, it's all these things, and I have written on this, and I believe that, you know, Daniel Snyder has to see the writing on the wall and react accordingly, and I think that they should change the name. Okay, I'm on the record as that. But as long as they're called the Washington Redskins, and as long as our newspaper, the Chicago Tribune, is referring to them and make an editorial decision to refer to them that way, then that's the way that I will refer to them. Now, you can do certain things in the context of your job as a broadcaster, as a writer, as a columnist, whatever, to write around using that name, to not bring up the name every time that you refer or call a play or refer to a quarterback. You know, you can find ways to limit the use of the word.
Yep.
But to come out and just say, I will not use the word because of my personal beliefs, when you're representing a company, a professional company, I don't think that you can do that.
I agree. I completely agree.
And I think, like, for me, where the gray area where I get frustrated is, if I was in their shoes, if they believe something, yet there's really no clarity on the company's stance, these guys as individuals. I mean, they're the ones saying the name. So it's not like it's going to go back, you know, NBC is racist. It's going to be like, well, no, Tony Dungy is saying the word Redskins. I don't like that. Do you know what I mean?
It does reflect on the network, though, ultimately.
I know that, yeah. But what I'm saying is, if they feel a different way than what the network feels,
right,
like, everybody's got to be on the same page about it. And there's still so much, like,
correct,
well, you
but
know,
if
I don't know.
If
I don't
it's
know.
The legal standing name of the team, and I'm Chris Farrow at ESPN, who, mm-hmm, you and I have worked for, and you say to me, I'm not saying the name Redskins, I said, then you're not doing the game. Period.
So part of working for that, you have to say the name and you have to take all the criticism that may come along with it.
There's no criticism. His name's been said for 80 years.
Okay, but not to this point where it's been such a hot button. So if fans start, I guess you have to be ready, if you do use that name, for fan backlash at that person directly.
I work for Fox TV. This is the policy. That's the name of the team. We're using it. You don't like it? Talk to my bosses.
And it's not like, it's not as if either guy has never represented their respective networks and said the name before.
Right.
If they were joining. Yeah,
that's my point. How
I know,
long have they
it's
been
not
calling
like it's
games?
Some new thing. That's why there's still a gray area. It's like, it was okay before. Is it not
but
now?
Here's,
where are we? What's going
you
on?
You do, when you have these sort of discussions and when you have this sort of these sort of issues, you do you split hairs. I mean, you have to do that. There's a very fine line between what you're willing to do and what you aren't willing to do. Tony Dungy is paid to be an analyst and have his opinion that carries a lot of weight in the NFL. If Tony Dungy wants to speak out on why this is a derogatory and offensive name, then I think that has value. But if he then takes that a step further and says, in the context of referring to Jay Gruden in his first season with the NFL team from Washington, and he refuses to use the name that his network has not come out and said, you know, we're not going to use this, if he made an editorial policy for an entire network, I don't think that's within his right. Tell me what you think about something, but don't establish policy for an entire network. And I think that's what they're doing here, or attempting to do. Now, will this lead to each network or either network making a decision about this? Maybe, perhaps, but they're clearly not ready to do that yet, or else they would have done it by now.
Correct.
It's too soon. We're too close to the NFL regular season that they have had this discussion. They've sat in the rooms. I've sat in the meetings downstairs on the fourth floor. What are we going to do about the Redskins? How are we going to address this? Are we going to go the route of other newspapers and not refer to them in print? Are we not going to do that? Arguments on both sides, very good, very strong, very defensible. Ultimately, someone has to make that decision. It's not the people. It's not me. Okay, it's not a sports columnist writing 4 or 5 days a week. It's somebody higher than that. That's why I think Tony Dungy and Phil Simms aren't those people.
So whose call is it, Jerry Kern?
Well, I think it's collective. It's somebody in that pay grade. It's somebody at that level. The editor, the publisher, the managing editor. Those are the kind of people that have this discussion to determine the course for, they make an editorial decision. That's what I think has to happen at these networks. Not Tony Dungy, not Phil Simms.
312-235-2525. If you were broadcasting or working for a broadcast company and your announcer said, I don't want to say that name, but that's the name of the team today. Doesn't matter that they might end up changing his name. Today, they are the Washington Redskins. You are broadcasting on a contract with the National Football League. Would you have a problem if your announcer said they wouldn't use it? Because I would. 312. They can go to do speeches and say, I don't support this. But when you're calling the game, you're working for the NFL and your TV company in a partnership. You do not have the right to impose your own way, in my opinion.
There's also ways to, you know, when you're writing something and something comes up and it's as awkward, it's bulky, you have to explain it. You know what you do? You write around it. And if you're on the air, you talk around it. There are ways to get around it. And I think that's what they have to figure out how to do. That doesn't mean you're backing off. It just means you're being sensitive to the idea that you don't make policy for an entire network.
Can he get there? Yes, he can. Jumping at third as Gillespie robbed him of extra bases. Yes, catch the ball, boys, and you're doing it. Strike three, got him. He go. Slam. Sox win. Sox win. And this ball game is over. Our kids just will not quit.
It's almost over.
We knew this moment would come.
Your last chance to get 0% financing for 72 months on most Ford models.
It's go time.
Yeah.
Feel the rush.
Let's go to work.
Don't miss the final days of the Ford Summer Spectacular.
Count me in.
It's the final days to get 0% financing for 72 months on almost every 2014 Ford vehicle. That's interest-free financing for 6 full years.
This Friday and Saturday, you can double your rebate. Get up to $250 in Visa prepaid cards when you buy select tire and wheel packages with your Discount Tire credit card. Double your rebate this Friday and Saturday. Thank you, Discount Tire.
Save big during the Great Hot Tub Clearance Event at The Great Escape, where you save up to $2,500 on top brands like Jacuzzi and Sundance. Plus, buy now and save up to an additional $1,500. Creative financing up to 48 months, only at The Great Escape.
The web is full of random stats and opinions.
But when it comes to the Bears, you can bet your season tickets. CSNChicago.com is bringing you the facts. John Moonmullen gives you an NFL vet's perspective and always has the inside track. Live post-game streams give you an instant reaction from Soldier. And Bears Pulse shows you what's trending at Soldier Field. From Bears fans for Bears fans, the Bears page on CSNChicago.com.
Derrick Rose rocking for Team USA, and my friend Fran Fraschilla got to call those games, and he is a star over at ESPN, a former college head coach. Fran was at New Mexico, St. John's. I coached in Manhattan, coached against him when he was at Ohio U, tormenting the officials with Danny Knee. Fran, good morning. How you doing, buddy?
Morning, Fran.
Phenomenal, guys. I'm in New York City, staying at a nice hotel. ESPN's paying for it. And I'm going to take a nice walk through Manhattan today as we get ready for a couple games this week at the Garden.
All right, let's talk about Derrick Rose first. People here excited. He got a great ovation on Saturday night. You've been watching him up close and personal. We get to see, you know, the one game when Paul George got hurt. We get to see clips. How does he look?
Well, he looks great. And, you know, first of all, Cap, let me just say this. I've had a chance to talk to him two or three times during the training camp. And what a great guy. You know, really, what a great, humble young guy, great representative of the Bulls in the city of Chicago. And I'm really, you know, one of those guys that you really root for. He is, you know what, he's not back to where he was in terms of MVP level right now, but based on what he's been through over 2 years and the way he's looked at practice and the glimpses you saw in the game, it's coming. You know, there's some conditioning issues, he said, that have to be worked through in time, and maybe some timing issues on the court, but I don't think there's anything to be concerned about at this point. I think these games in Spain are going to do him wonders because before training camp even starts, he's going to feel like he's already begun the comeback, and that I think bodes well for his season.
You know, Fran, when you see what's happened with Team USA, Paul George with the horrific injury, Kevin Durant pulling out, how did Derrick Rose's role change, or maybe the expectations? Because now you see he is maybe further along than people anticipated, and the team does need him maybe to be more of an attacker, an aggressor, a guy who gets, you know, scores rather than facilitates.
Well, not only that, but also the fact that he's one of the few veterans on this team that, you know, helped win a gold medal in 2010. And the fact that he's their point guard. So all those things, I think, make it a ready-made situation for Derek to lead. And it's something that I've talked to him about. He's embracing that. And so whether it's – I don't think it's going to be so much as scoring as much as just as facilitating and pushing the ball on the offensive end, pressuring the ball defensively. And then, you know, you always want your point guard to be a great leader, and he's done this in the past when he's been healthy. And I think this is going to be a natural progression for Derek, especially in light of the fact that, you know, Mike Krzyzewski's missing some of the guys that he hoped he'd have on his team.
Talking to Fran Fraschilla from ESPN. He's been calling the Team USA games. Take yourself out of the role you're in now, which you're so good at. Back on the sidelines, you're the head coach of the, oh, pick a team. You're Kevin Love's head coach. And would you want him playing in the FIBA World Championships, or would you say, dude, you're the heart and soul of my team. I can't have you getting hurt.
You know, it's a case-by-case basis, Cap, because Kevin Love made a very wise decision not playing simply because he's in the middle of this trade. He's you know, there's the talk of him getting the max deal at some point here when the Cavs can pull the trigger. I understand it completely. It makes perfect sense. Guy coming off an injury from a year ago, maybe Russell Westbrook, who's tweaked his knee a couple different times. Understandable. Even Kevin Durant, think about this. He's played in 98.4% of the Thunder's regular season games the last 4 years. He's averaged 39 minutes a game. I wish he'd done it earlier in terms of taking this break, but, you know, more power to these guys. I think, but when your contract situation's settled and you're feeling good about playing in the summer, I think USA basketball has been great for these guys. You go back and look at 2010, as we talked about. Durant came into his own. D. Rose came into his own. Westbrook came into his own. Kevin Love came into his own. So I think it's case by case, but by and large, I think USA basketball has been good for these guys. And by the way, you know, if you're an NFL player, you can't play off-season 11-on-11 anywhere. Same thing with baseball, unless you go down to the, you know, to the winter leagues. These guys, it's a culture of playing, and playing against the best, I think, by and large, is healthy.
You know, Fran, Derrick Rose had a great homecoming on Saturday night. The place was alive, and he responded. And, you know, he had 7 points, and he had the burst that was back. But I think of all the homecomings, Anthony Davis was the most impressive. This is the guy that almost stole the show. And I think that he has been the one player that, you know, if I don't know if surprise is the right word, but the way he has taken his game to the next level and offensively polished off some of those rough edges. Now he's taking jumpers. How impressed have you been with him, and have you been surprised?
Well, I'm not surprised, because getting ready for the summertime for USA Basketball, I went back and watched some Pelican tape. It's weird saying that, isn't it? Pelican tape?
Yeah.
And I think the only reason people are surprised by him is because he's really pretty much been in obscurity for 2 years down in New Orleans. The fact that they've had injuries, he's been injured, team hadn't done as well. But Kevin Durant told us 3 weeks ago in Las Vegas that Anthony Davis is the next NBA superstar. And certainly Saturday night was an opportunity for him to show that. And the one thing I've noticed over the course of training camp, and we talked to him yesterday, he's a very humble guy, very similar to D. Rose in terms of his attitude and the fact that he's still been unaffected by this fame. And yet you can see the confidence growing. And he's talking about being a confident player and being a dominating player. And he's the perfect example of a guy I talked about just a couple minutes ago that can utilize this world championship or FIBA World Cup run and catapult him to a level where people who are now watching him closely can say, you know what, this guy is unbelievable, and he's only 21 years old.
Talking to Fran Fraschilla here on 87.7 The Game, the Cap and Haw Show, also on Comcast Sportsnet. Would you ever rule out going back to coaching, because you're so good at the TV? I've gotten to work with you and call games. You're really good at it, but I know you loved being on the sideline.
You know, I love teaching, Cap, and I'm at the stage of my life where I think I've turned down so many opportunities to go back, and I'm so comfortable at ESPN. You know, you and I have had these discussions from time to time in the past, and now I think I've just taken I think there are less athletic directors out there that realize, you know, I say this humbly, the job I did. I mean, I still sometimes scratch my head and I go, why am I, you know, I won 67% of my games, but I fell into this broadcasting lifestyle in part as a family decision to watch, you know, my sons grow up.
Yep.
And thinking that maybe coaching would be there down the road. And what's happened is I got so comfortable with the role I have at ESPN and the things I get to do all year long. And, you know, I got a son who's a senior at Oklahoma playing, and my younger guy, Matt's going to be a sophomore playing at Harvard. So I made the right decision as far as the family decision, and ESPN's been great about it. I think now I'm pretty much past the time where an AD would say, hey, I'm going to hire that guy. It usually happens with somebody who I've known for a long, long time. But a younger AD who doesn't know what maybe I did in my coaching background, I don't think is like really would think about me or put me in the thought process. So I just motor on down the road for ESPN, and I'm so blessed to do what I'm doing. And I try to do it as well as I can, because I don't want somebody who knows the game to say, that guy didn't do his homework.
Fran, before we let you go, and you have done your homework on international players, we know you're an international basketball expert. So the Bulls are getting Nikola Mirotic to come aboard, yep, finally, after drafting him several years ago. What are realistic expectations for him in his rookie year?
Well, I love him. I love him as a long-term NBA player. I think he's not going to necessarily be an all-star, but I think he's going to end up being an above-average NBA starter. The dilemma and yet the blessing at the same time for Mirotic is that he's walking into a Bulls team that has a chance to win 60 games, and he's going to have to be patient playing behind Gasol, Gibson, and Noah, and that's not all bad. If you threw him on a team like the Pelicans, for example, we probably know about how good he is that much quicker. But at the same time, this kid has played at a level much higher than NCAA and proven he can be really good. And I've used this analogy before, guys. If the NCAA is double-A baseball, the league that he played in was triple-A, and now he's heading to the majors. The only difference is you can hit 300 in double-A, and it doesn't translate to the Cubs or White Sox. This is a kid that's, in my mind, hit, you know, 320 in triple-A, and he's ready for the major leagues, but he's got a few guys in front of him that he's going to have to just be patient and wait his turn. I think Tibbs is going to like the kid's toughness and work ethic. And I see him playing 16, 18 minutes a game as long as the big three up front are completely healthy.
Hey, before we let you go, the advent of the stretch four, which is what I call him, a stretch four, who could go out and knock down jump shots. Back in the day, 25 years ago, 20 years ago, you saw a guy his height. Hey, man, that's a little box down there we call the block. Get down there.
Yep.
And if you could run, they would use you a little bit more. The game has completely changed. Why?
Well, you know, it's changed in part, Cap, because, and I say this as a compliment to my European coaching friends, they took the game that we taught them and they turned it around and utilized it in a little bit different way than we have traditionally. And now, ironically, we see more stretch fours in college and the NBA than ever before. And the way I describe it, Cap, is we can walk into a museum and take a look at the Mona Lisa from dead on. That's the United States coaching way of looking at it. My European friends look at the same picture from a different angle and see something a little bit different from the masterpiece. And that's what they've done. The stretch four fit the European game for so long, the spacing, the driving, the kicking out for threes. And now it's become a huge part of the American game. So it's just cyclical, and I think that it's been healthy for the game that, you know, there's so many different ways to play it. And in that sense, the NBA has kind of learned from the European culture.
If you had a dollar for every dollar car insurance companies say they'll save you by switching, you'd have, like, a ton of dollars. But how are they saving you those dollars? A lot of companies might answer, or no comment. Then there's Esurance, born online, raised by technology, and majors in efficiency. So whatever they save, you save. Hassle, time, paperwork, hair tearing out, and yes, especially dollars. Esurance, insurance for the modern world. Now backed by Allstate. Click or call.
Our moving day arrived.
But the movers didn't.
All my jewelry? Lost.
Looked like a tornado hit the back of the truck.
But moving my DirecTV? Piece of cake.
They were so professional.
And on time.
Even gave me a brand new genie.
Bundled the phone and internet, too. All our favorite movies and shows. It's like we never left.
DirecTV was the best part of our move. By far.
The DirecTV Movers Deal. Call now and ask if you qualify for a free genie upgrade.
I'm Dr. Andy, the Kia man, and over in Kia, we're always fighting high prices. Yeah! And other people's high payments. Kia! Woo! Have no fear. Kia man is here, and I'll defend you from these guys, their high prices and their high payments, and all the other competition.
And you'll save hundreds on gas with our fuel-efficient Kias, like this new Kia Sportage, loaded with equipment and gets 28 miles per gallon. Only $18, $895, or $174 a month.
Take good care of my Kia, and we'll take good care of you.
Baseball is here, and the White Sox are in full swing.
Yes!
With over 100 live games.
Rack 'em up!
CSN is your home for Southside Baseball. Premium postgame shows to cover all the bases.
Mercy!
And we got the big hurt.
You can put it on the board, yeah!
So White Sox fans, when your team is playing, you know what it turns to and what to do.
Sit back, relax, and strap it down.
Comcast Sportsnet, the home of White Sox baseball.
The Bears page on csnchicago.com.
Are we writing for tomorrow?
No.
Wow. Got the whole day off. What are you going to do with yourself
exactly,
today?
Not exactly the whole day off, pal. Not planning to write for tomorrow.
We'll be
you
done in 14 minutes.
Yeah. You think, see, that's the thing. It's the beauty of guys who don't write for a living. They think you just sit down and 30 minutes later, you're done.
No, I was kidding you.
Okay. But an hour and a half later, you're done.
No, there's research.
There's
a lot
of stuff going on. Yeah, there's a lot of things going on. There's a lot of reporting to be done. There's a lot of stuff. Yeah, but I'm not planning to write for the paper tomorrow or the website yet.
So you won't just go home, put a movie on,
no,
get a little workout in,
right.
A little lunch with Allison.
Go on the treadmill. No.
Watch daytime TV, some soaps, some Cops.
Haven't done that in a while.
Rerun of Cops, maybe.
Yeah, this radio show kind of cramps your style.
I do watch Cops. So
replan your how you do a column. Make your life a little easier for you.
Yeah. When you do that, let me know.
Yeah.
I'll do the opposite. You see a story about your guy, Jerry Jones?
Which one?
Jerry Jones. Which Jerry Jones or which story?
No, I know which Jerry Jones.
Not the one that was on
which
the cover
story?
Of the New York Post. No,
right.
Not that story. The story where it comes out in a book where he had to be physically restrained from submitting the name of Johnny Manziel in the NFL draft. And his son was the one who physically restrained him. Yeah.
Wow. Story, but he's the GM.
The story is on ChicagoTribune.com, and it says that Jerry Jones did not deny a report he was physically restrained in the team draft room from turning in Texas A&M quarterback Johnny Manziel as the first-round pick. He said that Stephen Jones, CEO, and his son snatched the Manziel card straight out of Jerry Jones' hand.
Love it.
Figuratively speaking, it got close to that, Jones said on 105.3 FM in Dallas. It certainly was a big debate going on. So, yeah, the Jerry was going to do that, and Stephen's got in the way and snatched it out of his hand. Wouldn't that be great?
If he becomes a star.
No, Dad. No.
If he becomes a star, those guys are going to be so ticked when he's all over them.
They did the right thing. They did the right thing.
They actually didn't, because he's the owner and the GM. If he truly wanted it, they would have gotten
that
pick.
You can save people from themselves, and that's exactly what they did in this case. They got a quarterback. Tony Romo's pretty good.
Yeah.
And you have a team that is prone to distractions. But could you imagine the same thing here? Wouldn't it be something if, like, there was that story in Chicago and George McCaskey wanted to go and he had to be restrained by Pat?
That would be so funny.
Yanking the card out of the hand of Phil Emery. No, Phil. Kyle Fuller. Not Johnny. Kyle Fuller.
I could just never see George McCaskey behaving that way.
No, I don't think so.
God, that would be so hilarious.
Hey, is tonight Hard Knocks?
Tuesday. I believe tonight
Hard
is
Knocks
Hard Knocks
night. Yeah. Going to be an interesting one. Sam Baker, our guy. Remember David Baker sat here in the studio? You will never forget that interview.
The largest person I've ever seen.
Largest man ever in the studio.
Yeah, no question.
His son had a very difficult injury.
Yep.
Tore his, ruptured his tendon.
Patella tendon, yeah.
Patella tendon.
Out for the year.
And that's a bad one.
So they moved Matthews. Yeah.
To the left Jake side. Matthews,
you know that's going to be a big storyline tonight, though.
I would think so.
I hope it gets better. Ben, I'm waiting for this to get to the point where you talk about it at 12 o'clock and you can't wait to watch it. I don't know that's happened yet.
No, I still like the show. It's still cool to see the behind the scenes and all that, but it's been a pretty lame season compared to the other ones.
Yeah,
I completely agree.
And last week they spent a lot of time on Prince Shembo.
Too much Shembo.
I thought was a little uncomfortable. It's hard to watch him without thinking about what he did
for us,
or what he's accused
I don't know
of
the
doing.
People in Atlanta care. I don't know if people of the Falcons care. I think people that are familiar with his past and have an issue with his past at Notre Dame watch that uncomfortably. Yeah, but beyond that, I don't know.
There's no great personality on that team.
No, Matt Ryan is likable, but not in a way that.
You know what? He's come off very well, but not. He's not Martellus Bennett or Brandon Marshall.
No, he's not goofy.
He's not a showman.
He's a professional.
He's looked very good.
He reminds me of Peyton Manning going into meeting rooms, you know, checking things out. Very cerebral quarterback.
He walked into the receiver's room, gave a tip to Roddy White, walked out. It was kind of nice. And
I like him. I liked him when he was coming out.
Elite? Is he on your elite list?
He's flirting with it.
Him and Jay.
He's better than Jay.
Well, see, you say that, but you forget the list, and we could find that if we had archives.
The Jaworski list?
Your list of top 12 quarterbacks, I think that Matt Ryan and Jay Cutler were comparable. 11, 10, 10, 11?
No, I had Jay 16.
Okay, maybe that's my list.
Your list had Jay 11, yeah.
And maybe Matt Ryan 12 or 10-ish.
You had him higher so you could walk in at Hal's and go, hey, Jay, I ranked you higher.
Yeah, yeah, you think I'm going to do that? I can't wait till I do that. Is Jay talking today, by the way, or is that tomorrow?
I don't know.
I'm not sure.
But both of those guys have something in common. They both need to win in the postseason.
Absolutely.
So does Romo.
And absolutely, too. Which quarterback doesn't need to win in the postseason?
But Peyton Manning's legacy is established.
Exactly.
Tom Brady's established. Matt Ryan, coming off a horrific year, has got to step it up and get them into the postseason and win.
We know he can win in the regular season. We've seen it before. He's got to win some games.
How good about this season, though, must you feel, seriously, if you're Jay Cutler? You just signed Santonio Holmes. And how about Santonio Holmes saying that Jay Cutler took him under his wing? So this is a second new player who, with a troubled past, Jimmy Clausen and Holmes, who have come in and credited Cutler for doing what leaders are supposed to do, making it easier for the new guy to adjust. How must you feel, though, if you're Cutler and you think you've already got arguably the best receiver tandem in football? You've got Martellus Bennett. Who
got Matt Forte.
You got Forte in the backfield. You've got Holmes who has, if he can, that's what you're thinking, the possibility. If he can learn this offense, if he can be a shadow of the guy that he used to be, this is one dynamic offense. I don't know that the list of skill position players, you look at Forte, Marshall, Jeffrey, Bennett, and Holmes, that's hard to beat. That's hard to top.
It's pretty good.
Especially with Cutler.
Better keep that line healthy.
And what Cutler has to do is be Jay Cutler without the mistakes. Keep thinking big, throwing deep, using that arm, but limit, you know, listen to the voice in your head that says, no, that's a bad idea.
Please keep the line healthy. Jordan Mills, good news, got the walking boot off. Will not play against the Seahawks.
I think that's going to be an issue. I think that to me is emerged as one of the bigger concerns of preseason.
Says he feels better.
Players always say that. You know, players always say that. And
you're going to tell me Mr. Debbie Downer over there?
Debbie Downer. I just gave you a reason for optimism for Jay Cutler.
He got the walking boot off. That's a step in the right direction.
He's not played all preseason. And he was a guy, of all the players on that offensive line, had the biggest room for growth. I'm just saying, there is a weak link on that offensive line that everyone has assumed will be a strength of this team. It still may be. But, you know, they like to say, five as one. You've been working without your fifth guy. And I think that could be something that goes and carries into the season. You don't want that to carry into the season. If his first action of meaning alongside Kyle Long is against the Buffalo Bills, which it probably will be, you know, that's not good. Not ideal. That's all I'm saying. I'm not Debbie Downer. I just said good things about Jay Cutler. Come on.
Okay.
It's more than you say about Jay Cutler.
I say nice things about Jay. I am not an anti-
Oh, you say it so he can go on your talk show?
No. Never had Jay on the talk show. No.
Never met Jay.
Never had an interaction with him.
I got a couple emails on that saying, was Cap being serious when he said that?
Never even asked him to come on the show because he's not going to. He's doing the stuff with ESPN. If he wants to come on, love to have him.
Open invitation.
Open invite for Jay. But no, I've always been on the Cubs beat more than the Bears beat since, late 90s was when I stopped covering the Bears. 2000 maybe? Right there.
Well, I would suggest this to CSN since, you know, the whole partnership now. I think that CSN's the next inside look.
Jay Cutler with me.
Yeah.
That'd be awesome.
I know it would be. It'd be a great programming decision.
That would be compelling TV.
It would be. If he would let that happen. I mean, look, those are what, 30-minute interviews?
Yeah.
30-minute interview with Jay Cutler, I think you could learn a lot. I think he could win over. He's consistently won over people.
Right.
The more open he is, the more relaxed he is.
If he did a 30-minute Jay inside look.
The kind of the with the tone that those stories tend to be.
Right. It's more just
you're not going into, hey, Jay, here's your 2007 tax return. Explain this. No.
No.
Tell me about your organization, your foundation. Why didn't you pay this? No, you're like, hey, Jay, when you were 12 years old, your dad dragged you to Evansville to play youth football for the first time.
And you know
you're going to be a quarterback.
Right.
And he talks about things because nostalgia.
You battle diabetes. Take us through what that challenge has been.
Absolutely.
To be an elite quarterback or at that level play in the NFL and battle type 1 diabetes.
Because of what I think are good about these shows, and I do like them.
I just taped them with Anthony Rizzo.
Yeah, because
I'm sure he'd love to talk about being a father.
Well, they're relatable.
Two now, right?
They talk about things that are relatable to people. You can't really relate to Jay Cutler breaking down the defense, dropping back and picking out the right receiver. But you can relate to what that was like, going through an illness, overcoming something, being a regular guy.
Oh, the $4 menu presents many options, yet grants us only one stomach.
Master?
How does one decide between the original double and cheese or the fresh guacamole steak burger?
The garlic double steak burger.
Or an all-beef Chicago-style football?
How do you decide, Master?
Pictures.
The $4 menu, where all meals are under $4. At Steak and Shake.
Do you feel trapped by your credit cards? $25,000 in balance now means your minimum payment could be $1,000 a month. Be late, and there go the late charges. I'm attorney Peter Francis Geraci. Consider eliminating with Chapter 7 or no interest repayment under Chapter 13. Call us for a free phone mini consultation or log on to infotapes.com.
If you're worried about debt, call now to see if you qualify. 1-800-401-4010.
The Sonata Premier Event, featuring the dramatically redesigned 2015 Hyundai Sonata. It's the first Sonata with forward collision warning, the first with lane departure warning, and the first to earn the Insurance Institute's highest safety rating. So the next time you hear the phrase safety first, think Sonata first.
Lease the all-new 2015 Sonata for $199 a month. Visit buyhyundai.com.
Chicago District Golfer is celebrating the CDGA's 100th anniversary all year long with the best courses, insightful instruction, game-improving equipment, and interesting stories. Join me, Jill Carlson, on the first Sunday of every month at 9:30 p.m.
Don't miss Sports Talk Live on Comcast Sportsnet. David Kaplan leads a roundtable on the day's hottest topics. Sports Talk Live, presented by the all-new Chevy Silverado. Weeknights on Comcast Sportsnet.
Welcome back. We have been in a delay for over 3 hours here at Wrigley Field. It rained for maybe 15 minutes, but it was the deluge of all deluges and kind of the perfect storm, I guess pun intended, Jim Deshays. Hunter Wendelstedt called for the tarp, but it was after it was raining really, really hard, and in the grounds crew's haste to get the tarp on the infield as quickly as possible, as they were putting the tarp on the field, it wasn't completely straight, and then all the water collected in the middle of the tarp, and they had a heck of a time getting the tarp to cover all the dirt on the infield, and we're just not sure if the field's going to be playable at some point this evening / morning.
Yeah, so there's standing water out there for a good long while out at the shortstop position out at and behind second base. And at various times over these 3 hours, we've seen the decision makers out there, the umpires, people from the Cubs, and the managers have been walking the infield and talking about it and just trying to read their lips and their actions. A couple different times, I was of the mind that they were going to go, hey, let's just bang it. We're not going to play baseball. But the longer we wait, the more I think we are going to play baseball. Otherwise, you know, why have we waited this long? So we'll see. It's a bizarre night at the ballpark. I've never seen anything quite like it.
So, you know, we haven't been told anything by any officials from either team or the umpires or MLB. We've looked at the rule book. Just through deductive reasoning, if there was some sort of rule to allow the suspension of this game and the resumption of it tomorrow, I think they would have made that decision already, right? We're over 3 hours into this delay.
Yes.
So
I'm with you.
What I think is happening right now is they're waiting, and there's nothing more the grounds crew can do. Roger Baird's out there, you know, doing his best to, you know, rake the parts of the infield that are problematic, but I'm not sure there's anything more they can do other than hope that the infield dries enough to allow this game to resume. And if that's not the case, this is a complete game, and I think the Cubs will be granted a victory.
Right. There's a, you know, a clause in the rule book that talks about suspension due to mechanical failures of the automatic tarpaulin, or if the lights were to crash all of a sudden, you know. But there's nothing about, you know, the inability to get the tarp on time or in a timely manner, or, you know, the conditions being what they were, the wind was blowing and howling. Hunter Wendelstedt waited. You know, he asked for the tarp kind of late. I think he was hoping it wouldn't rain that hard and they could kind of push through. So I don't think the clause that's in the rule book pertains to this situation. And even if, you know, you want, in a spirit of fairness and common sense, you were to argue, well, they should suspend the game. The Giants are in this pennant race. They should suspend the game and resume. If it's not in the rules, you really can't do that because the teams they're competing with are going to, you know, raise holy,
right, and you create a precedent.
Yeah.
Yes.
So,
Yeah, this is not the World Series in 2008 with the Phillies and the Rays. This is a regular season game, and unless they change the rule book, again, we don't know of any specific rule that would allow for a suspension of a game that the losing team has had five cracks at it, which the Giants have had.
Meanwhile,
and yes, the common sense is just suspend it and continue because it doesn't seem fair, but that's not how the rules are stated. And I also think that's why we're waiting as long as possible.
Right.
But I think everybody involved understands that, you know, it doesn't seem fair to call this game. And so that's why I think we're going to wait 3.5, 4, maybe 5 hours before at some point determining that the field is either ready to play and we play the back half of this game, or that it's just not going to be playable before the sun comes up tomorrow morning.
Yeah, whatever that point in time is.
Yeah.
We don't know, but... Yeah, I'm with you. I think if there was under the rules a way that this game could be a suspended game, it already would have been deemed so by now.
So that's where we stand. And by the way, you know, there's a lot of blame being thrown around on Twitter about the grounds crew or the umpires or whatever. I think this was the perfect storm in that I'm not even sure this cell was on the radar, because Roger Baird, the head groundskeeper, did talk to Hunter Wendelstedt as it started to rain during the commercial, and it only rained for about 15 minutes total. I'm not sure anybody knew quite how hard it was going to rain, and if it had just drizzled for that 15 minutes, JD, we wouldn't have had a delay. So I think this thing caught everybody by surprise, and it just, the grounds crew was kind of put in a bad spot from Jump Street, and then we know what happened.
Yeah, they scrambled.
They did what they could
to get after it, and just, you know, yeah, stuff happens, right? I mean, just
right.
people want to fix blame. It just
happened. Yeah. So that's where we stand, and we'll have more updates as we continue during this delay. We have not seen anybody go out and play catch. We see the managers still sitting in the dugouts. We see the bats and the Gatorade jugs still in the dugouts. Sometimes in these cases, the game is called, but we're not alerted until 15, 20 minutes later. That has not happened here. So we are still waiting, and we'll have updates from the ballpark. Chris Bowden with Sportsnet Central coming your way. Stay tuned.
Hi, everyone. Welcome into Sportsnet Central, presented by CLR. I'm Chris Bowden. Derrick Rose's comeback gets a road bump. Should the former MVP quit Team USA?
League will be here this weekend. Rizzo, towering blast. Way back.
Chicago's star first baseman looked to power the Cubs and Sox to victories. The Bears prepare to take on the defending champs. And the Hawk steps up for the Ice Bucket Challenge.
I don't think the heavy stuff's going to come down for quite a while.
Sportsnet Central starts right now.
To Sportsnet Central, presented by CLR.
Two Chicago baseball teams are done with their games. Another night, another elimination game facing Jackie Robinson West at the Little League World Series in Weymouthport. After rallying to stay alive Monday night against Rhode Island, last night's do-or-die date was against Texas. But Team Illinois had Houston, Joshua Houston, that is, on the mound for them. He comes out dealing in the first, striking out the side. He'd go on to throw a dominating five frames, allowing only four hits and one run. Now to the bottom of the fourth, Houston helping himself out at the plate, doubling deep to left and driving in his second and third runs of the game, give Jackie Robinson West a 6-1 lead. And that would be your final. An outstanding two-way performance from Houston as Jackie Robinson West stays alive again, pulling it within one win of the U.S. Championship. They'll next face the loser of Wednesday's matchup to determine who advances to the American title game. Here are the team's family members and coach afterwards.
6-1, you know, it was all the way to the end. It's pretty important. We live to fight another day.
Thought they would hit a little more, but we didn't. They played really good defense, so awesome game.
Unfortunately, we had to come out of loser's bracket, but we're putting wins together in bunches, and let's keep that up.
I'm excited for the city of Chicago, you know, state of Illinois.
it's just a lot going on right now, so I'm super excited.
You got 5 seconds here, Mark, 4.6, so D. Rose going to try to go wing to the court.
He has some kind of different speed, so that's Derrick Rose. And back in kind, responding here in Chicago. That looked like Usain Bolt with a basketball.
Jazz have his rights.
Yeah, he's not guarding Derrick Rose, though.
No, he's not.
I'll tell you what, that guy is quicker than gossip, folks.
Tuesday marked a third straight day of Derrick Rose not playing basketball following Saturday night's encouraging homecoming for Team USA at the United Center. It was also a second straight practice that he missed ahead of tonight's exhibition versus the Dominican Republic at Madison Square Garden. Chris Sheridan reported that Rose is experiencing knee soreness, and there's concern among Team USA officials he won't be able to withstand the World Cup tournament schedule. Rose and his Bulls boss didn't sound as concerned.
I didn't do anything today but got treatment, and really just today is another rest day. I'm really, really happy where I'm at right now as far as health-wise, recovering very quickly, and just trying to take my time and get rest because we have a long schedule ahead of us and just try to get as much rest as possible.
We knew it would be a process. You know, we have to be patient. He's got to continue to work his way through it. But we like the fact that he's been very explosive. The speed and quickness is back. And he's got to shake off the rust. And the only way you can do that is by playing. So just take it day by day and concentrate on improvement.
Here's a closer look at that intense World Cup schedule following the three exhibitions that remain. It all starts a week from Friday in Spain. And the games come fast and furious to the tune of 5 in 6 days. Then, after an off day following that opening slate of games, the round of 16 begins. With more on D. Rose, here's Pat Boyle.
We're now joined by CSNChicago.com Bulls insider Agray Sam. All right, Agray, how concerned should Bulls fans be with this latest report?
I've heard, you know, conflicting accounts. You know, I've had a source tell me that, yes, you know, the knee soreness is, you know, a concern, and this is why Derrick is missing, you know, multiple days of practice. And somebody else who tells me, you know, it's more of a precautionary thing, and the concern more is about the amount of games in a short period of time. Either way, you know, the fact that they're not, you know, pushing him through it, I think it's a good thing. Obviously, Tibbs is there. The Bulls director of athletic performance, Jen Swanson, is also with the team. So they're keeping a close eye on Derrick. And obviously, with the 2 seasons that he's missed, essentially, I mean, he played 10 games last year, 10 regular season games. I think that Bulls fans should be, you know, happy that there's this level of concern about, you know, him not, you know, exacerbating any kind of even small situation.
If the report is true and he is experiencing knee soreness and Team USA playing 8 games in the next 16 days, do you think Rose will drop out of the FIBA World Cup and Team USA?
You know, it's hard to tell. You know, I don't want to say I'm in Derrick's head or anything like that. But from, you know, the Kevin Durant pulling out situation, the Paul George injury, I was always kind of in the back of my mind thinking, you know, Derrick could pull out as well. One of the big benefits of him playing on Team USA is the fact that he wasn't expected to really carry a big burden for the team. With the roster the way it is now, and still very good NBA players, but without those superstars on the roster, I think that there is a much bigger burden if he does play, you know, throughout the whole FIBA World Cup. And, you know, if he is experiencing some knee soreness, you know, I think better safe than sorry might be the approach.
All right, let's say Derrick Rose decides to stay with Team USA. Should Bulls management force him to drop off Team USA?
It's a tough call because you do want him to get that experience, kind of get some of that rust off, but you don't want him to, you know, risk further damage if, you know, the knee soreness is something that, you know, is that much of a concern. And again, the team's top priority, as is Derrick's, is him being healthy throughout the course of the NBA season. I don't know if they'll force him, but I think it's something that will be discussed in the coming days.
Agray Sam, there is no offseason in the NBA. We'll be checking out your work at CSNChicago.com.
All right, thanks a lot, Pat.
Cubs and White Sox both in town, both under the lights. It did not rain on both sides of town, but both all-star first basemen provided some early thunder with their sticks. Let's start on the north side, series opener for the Cubs and Giants. Bottom one after Javier Baez drew yet another walk. Anthony Rizzo launches to Sheffield, real far. His 29th off Ryan Vogelsong makes it 2-0 Cubs. Just a few minutes later, on the south side, not to be outdone, Jose Abreu evens things up with a big solo shot to left center, breaking an 18-game homerless drought spanning 77 at-bats. That ties that game at one. Then, prior to the fourth inning, Hawk Harrelson accepts the ice bucket challenge in support of ALS awareness. Southpaw and Jim Thome dumped the buckets on him. We'll have more on that later in the show. Meanwhile, 8 miles north, the skies open. How about this for a bucket challenge? It starts pouring at Wrigley. Umps believed it would be a short delay. Didn't call for the tarp right away. No rain, though, about the same time. On the south side, maybe the Sox started wishing it was when Delmon Young snaps the one-all tie with a base hit to center. That puts the Birds on top, 2-1. And a couple of batters later, Chris Davis takes one into the gap off of Jose Quintana to bring home a pair. Just like that, it is 4-1 in favor of Baltimore. Meanwhile, big issues on the north side. The grounds crew struggling to get the tarp completely over the infield dirt. It's coming down in buckets. Even though the storm was short, there would be an extended delay, and that delay is continuing at this moment. Back on the south side, Daniel Webb serves up the long ball to Nick Hundley in the seventh. That makes it a 5-1 ball game. That would be the final as the Sox manages three hits for a second straight night, dropping the first two games of the series and falling 8 games under 500. Now, back to the north side. The grounds crew worked furiously once the tarp came off about 9 o'clock, applying dozens of bags of Diamond Dry on the infield once they pushed the standing water from the storm off of the dirt. Umpiring crew and managers Rick Renteria of the Cubs and Bruce Bochy of the Giants have gone out a couple of times to assess the conditions, only to have the grounds crew do additional work, including eventually removing some of the heavy areas of Diamond Dry. We await word on whether the action will continue tonight on Clark and Addison. It has still not been called, or there's been no official word on whether we will ever continue this morning. The Bears avoid the elements by moving indoors to practice and pump up the volume to 12th man levels as they prepare to take on the Super Bowl champions. And as we showed you a moment ago, Hawk Harrelson has played in the World Series, an All-Star game, even the British Open, but nothing in his career would prepare him for the Ice Bucket Challenge.
Sportsnet Central is presented by CLR. We make cleaning cleaner.
Cleaning away calcium, lime, and rust buildup is cleaner with CLR. It's safe enough to carry the EPA Designed for the Environment label, yet it has a powerful cleaning formula that you can trust to dissolve tough calcium and lime deposits and surface rust stains quickly and easily. Crusty white buildup on shower heads and hard water stains from coffee pots. Plus, it helps dishwashers and washing machines clean better. Safe, effective CLR. We make cleaning cleaner.
CLR is available at these fine stores.
It's the model year end, and we're unleashing the 2014 Nissan Altimas. Bottom line, Altima is the most exciting sedan on the road.
During Nissan's Bottom Line, get 0% APR for up to 60 months on Altima, plus save up to $500.
Innovation that excites.
Shop ChooseNissan.com.
Tonight, the White Sox and Orioles meet for the final time in 2014, and the boys on the South Side look to close with a win. White Sox, Orioles, tonight at 7 on Comcast Sportsnet. Download the Great Clips app today so you don't miss out on what you want to do. On Wednesday, September 17th, join Chicago Sportsnet's Pat Boyle and other local sports celebrities at the brand new Chicago Sports Museum for the 6th annual Good Sports Legends of the Ball Gala. This special fundraiser is in support of Good Sports, a nonprofit which helps ensure that Chicago area youth have the opportunity and equipment to play sports and have an active lifestyle for years to come. Visit goodsports.org for tickets.
We welcome you back to Sportsnet Central. Roughly 3 hours after removing the tarp, we remain in a field condition delay at Wrigley Field. A brief but powerful storm struck in the bottom of the fifth with the Cubs leading the Giants 2-0. Actually, it was between the top and bottom half. Soak the infield before the tarp could get completely on. We will keep you posted as the umpiring crew. Both teams say they are hoping to finish the game tonight. Time now for our Bears preseason coverage presented by Apt. Cutler, Marshall, Jeffrey against the best secondary in the NFL, and the Bears O-line against that nasty Seahawks defensive front. Mel Tucker, revamped side of the ball versus Marshawn Beast Mode Lynch. Mark Trestman probably couldn't ask for a better gauge for his squad in the most important preseason game Friday, opposite the Legion of Boom and the defending champs and their rabid supporters. Threatening skies above Hallis Hall wasn't the only reason the Bears chose to move practice indoors. It was also an opportunity to prepare for Seattle's famous 12th man. The Seahawks crowd at CenturyLink Field, whose noise level will be in mid-season form to cheer on their defending champion Seahawks.
It's rough as a younger guy to go into a stadium like that and know at times it's going to be hard to hear in the huddle. You know, third preseason game, I'm sure that not only will the team be amped up, but the fans know it's like it's the closest to a regular season game they're going to get. So it's going to be a good experience for them.
Any third preseason game is a really a good test to see where you're at, because that's when most of the starters are playing for an extended period of time, and also, you know, you actually game plan a little bit against them.
We have to go there and play. It's going to be loud. It's going to be a test for our offense. It's going to be a test for each one of us individually up front. And we just have to make sure that we're ready to go.
You know, I like the group of guys that we have in the locker room, understand what we're doing offensively. And it's early. It's still preseason with you guys.
This trip to Seattle also prepares the Bears for a big game environment and closer to defining themselves on special teams, including candidates who are expecting to fill the shoes of the departed Devin Hester.
Anytime you're in a competition, you got to be excited. And, you know, what better place to do it at than in Chicago?
My main thing was just staying in shape, and whenever a team does call, I'm right up in a porous. I feel like I never left playing football. So right now, my main thing was getting in shape, and I showed a lot yesterday that I was in shape, and here I am.
We're not fully game planning this team. We're still going to go out and work, but there'll be the matchups that we're looking for, and it'll be ones-on-ones for however long we do it. We'll see what happens as these matchups take place throughout the game, but we're not going to take ourselves to a place where it means more than it is.
Time for our Comcast Business Edge. How's this for a home field advantage? Over the last two seasons, the Seahawks and their 12th man are 15-1. That lone defeat came last December against Arizona. They also have the highest point differential in the NFL over the past 2 years at home, outscoring opponents by 271 points in the Emerald City, giving the Seahawks the edge. Comcast Business Edge, sports at the speed of business. Notre Dame looks like they will be without four key players due to academic scandal, but it was the man who missed last season on the sidelines who will be expected to carry the offense. Plus, Hawk Harrelson, a man of his word, but he had a surprise guest as he took the Ice Bucket Challenge. Once again, Cubs and Giants in delay about 3.5 hours since the tarp's been removed. It appears as though the umpiring crew and the team's just waiting to see if the soaked infield dirt will dry enough to ever make resumption possible. No timetable has been given. We're waiting like you are.
Bears preseason coverage is presented by Apt Electronics, appliances, and more since 1936. We are driven by our instincts, a craving for design, a passion for performance, for power. The result is undeniable. The Infiniti Q50. Follow that instinct. Lease the Infiniti Q50 with all-wheel drive for $369 a month. Visit your local Infiniti retailer. Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
The future belongs to those who know where they belong.
What if I don't fit in?
They call it divergent.
Divergence threaten the system. It won't be safe until they're removed.
If you want to survive, we have to be ready for anything.
I want them hunted down. Every single one.
Divergent. Movies start at Channel 125.
Hi, I'm Donna Lawler of Gerald Subaru. We are one of an elite group awarded the Subaru Stellar Care Award for excellence in customer satisfaction. That's one reason over 62% of our customers are repeat or referral customers. Drive home today in the Subaru of your choice, because we have the largest inventory in Chicagoland, and our vehicles are backed by the Gerald exclusive lifetime warranty, which means unlimited coverage anywhere you want to service your vehicle. Gerald Subaru of Naperville is always a better deal. I guarantee it.
I'm not much of a shopper, and I got a lot going on, so it's good to know farmandfleet.com is there.
I have got a million things to do. When I think of things that I need, I jot them down, and I go to farmandfleet.com, and I do all my shopping.
I can just finish what I'm doing, grab my phone, see all the products I want, just order them right there online.
I just place my order, and I pick it up at the store.
I just pick it up and go. They make it easy.
It's so easy and convenient.
Cap'n Hall Rewind, weeknights at 11.
Pablo Sandoval's enjoying himself as the waiting game continues for him, the Giants, the Cubs, and their fans on whether the infield conditions will allow completion of tonight's game, with the Cubs leading 2-0 in the bottom of the fifth. As Notre Dame deals with the suspensions of four players who are part of an academic fraud investigation at the school, the quarterback, who had a year-long dismissal for that reason, is back in a starting role. Everett Golson helped the Irish to the BCS championship game as a redshirt freshman a little over a year and a half ago, only to be punished for his classroom actions a couple of months later. He was reinstated last December, his eligibility restored this school year. His competition for the starting job with Malik Zaire didn't last long. For Golson, it only took a few snaps watching the Irish last season to realize the error of his ways.
The first couple games, it was kind of embarrassing, to be honest. I watched the Temple game, and I felt kind of bad. You know, just seeing all those guys out there. I think. The biggest thing I saw Amir, you know, break off on that run, and it just really sunk in, like, oh man, I'm not there.
He knows what great leadership looks like, and he's paid attention to it and knows what it looks like, and now he's that guy out in front, and he's not the guy behind.
The plays of the day are presented by Lexus.
Out to Williamsport for number three, Joshua Houston, earning this spot, allowing just one run over five innings of pitching. Drove in three runs, including a pair of insurance runs here in the fourth. As Jackie Robinson West goes on to win 6-1 and survives to play another day in the Little League World Series. Two crosstown homers for number two. Jose Abreu went yard in the first at U.S. Cellular Field, his first long ball since July 29th. And over at Wrigley, also in the first, Anthony Rizzo deposited a towering shot on a Sheffield Avenue, his second homer in as many days. The slugging Chicago first baseman share our number two play out to Fenway. For number one, Boston's Brock Holt belts one deep to right. Cole Calhoun tracks it back to the wall and makes a spectacular leaping catch, robbing Holt of a sure home run. Calhoun helps the Angels prevail 4-3 and takes home our play of the day.
My first challenge is going to go out to one of the great left-handed relievers in Major League Baseball history, now with MLB Network, Dan Plesac. And my third challenge, when I announce this name, everybody in the White Sox organization is going to give me a standing O, because it is our trainer, Herm Schneider. You are challenged. You're on the clock, buddy.
Well, the shower cap didn't help too much. Maybe Hawk thought Southpaw would be the only one dousing him. But in case you didn't catch it, the man in the purple shirt in the background and really giving Hawk a soaking is former White Sox slugger Jim Tomei. Hawk didn't get out of the way with his duck walk quickly enough. But good on him to take part in the Ice Bucket Challenge to support ALS funding and research. He gets my play of the day. That's a wrap for this edition of Sports Set Center presented by CLR. We are standing by to find out what's going to happen with this Cubs game. It hasn't been called off just yet. We will keep you posted. Len and Jim from the ballpark on what a final decision will be. Cubs on top of the Giants, 2-0 in the bottom of the fifth right now.
Does anyone know a trustworthy roofer?
I need a ranked list of roofers with detailed reviews.
Carol, you know you can find that online, right? You can even buy homeowners insurance online from eSurance. I am desperate for a roofer.
That's not how it works.
Now you can buy homeowners insurance online with Esurance. Their simple, intuitive tools help guide you to the right coverage for your home. You can even get money back every year you don't make a claim. Welcome to the modern world. Esurance, backed by Allstate. Visit Esurance.com for a quote.
Matt, what do we got going on here today?
Well, we put an addition on this home.
Before we start painting, obviously we got to prep. We got exterior and interior 3M Scotch-Blue Painter's Tape. The exterior tape can hold up to the elements, the wind, the rain, the hot sun, the humidity. It has a waterproof backing. One of my favorite things about this tape, it has a quick snap tear. Also, it comes off cleanly up to 7 days. It's the perfect tape to use for exterior painting. Available at the Home Depot.
It's almost over.
We knew this moment would come.
Your last chance to get 0% financing for 72 months on most Ford models.
It's go time.
Yeah.
Feel the rush.
Let's go to work.
Don't miss the final days of the Ford Summer Spectacular.
Count me in.
It's the final days to get 0% financing for 72 months on almost every 2014 Ford vehicle. That's interest-free financing for 6 full years.
Do you feel trapped by your credit cards? $25,000 in balance now means your minimum payment could be $1,000 a month. Be late, and there go the late charges. I'm attorney Peter Francis Geraci. Consider eliminating with Chapter 7 or no interest repayment under Chapter 13. Call us for a free phone mini consultation or log on to infotapes.com.
If you're worried about debt, call now to see if you qualify. 1-800-401-4010.